Good evening, everyone. I can't hear you. Are you sleeping? Yeah. I, Akash, and my river mate Sagnik are going to present the last presentation of the day. So don't worry, we won't let you doze off with our presentation.
So before I start with the presentation, I don't want from the audience anyone throwing eatables or some crabs or pencils in the stage. Because yesterday only India lost the semis, and you might be thinking that again these two guys have come for the presentation on the topic IPL. So before starting off with the presentation, I would like, rather than asking you the question that how many of you are IPL fans, I know quite a large number, but I would like to ask how many of you are CSK fans? And how many of you are MI fans? Oh, forget man. This is the most rival team of CSK because I am the CSK fans. So our topic is impact of social media marketing in business, a case study of IPL.
So our content would be introduction of IPL, what is social media marketing, how IPL is doing social media marketing, sponsors and revenue generated by IPL, its competitors, SWOT analysis, and then we will conclude the slide. Introduction. On 13 September 2007, BCCI announced the T20 League IPL. But before that, India has already launched another league known as Indian Cricket League, which was a failure because BCCI did not support that. Then BCCI President Lalit Modi did a lot of research because European football leagues were getting lots of popularity and they were generating lot of revenue. So he introduced IPL based on these types of leagues. And the team names were given according to the cities to attract the audience so that they can relate themselves with the league.
So our main topic is how social media marketing is helpful in IPL.
Just stop the presentation there. I mean, this is ridiculous. So much of talking at the back, loud. Please. Just cooperate with us, please. Yeah.
So first is creating and sharing of content on social media network. See, if you are doing a business, so first the foremost important thing which you have to do is network. You have to create a great network. So I would like to give you an example. Who is the founder of Flipkart? Sachin Bansal and Binny Bansal, right? So Sachin Bansal, at first he used to receive 100 orders per day, and he used to sell door to door. So that is how he created a social network. Next slide. And then to achieve your marketing goals, you have to brand your products. So he used to sell a huge number of books, and other than books also he used to sell some stuffs, and he used to receive 100 orders per day. And then he created the website. Website, we all know that Flipkart. In that he used images, videos, video contents, like all other items also he made available in Flipkart. This is how he used to engage the audience. Means we all got attracted to Flipkart, and this is how we all get engaged with the networking site. And he as well as paid social media advertising. Okay, sorry ma'am.
Now how IPL is doing social media marketing. At start IPL, they created lots of Facebook pages of different teams and also of main IPL event. And can anyone tell which of the franchisee has most fans?
It's CSK, right?
No. It's Mumbai Indians. When Twitter accounts were opened of IPL, it generated approximately 9 crore tweets in 2 days. Over 100 unique films of 15 seconds were created and promoted on Facebook, like Zuzu, and these days Swiggy, Matchday Mania, and etc. First, and it became the first sporting event to broadcast live matches on YouTube.
So now the sponsorship. Before coming to the sponsorship, I was about to ask this question to you, that who was the first broadcasting sponsor? No, not the title sponsor, broadcasting sponsor. It was Sony. It's a title sponsor, not broadcasting. Media sponsor I'm asking about. So Sony was the first broadcasting sponsor, and wait. And he won by a winning bid of 8800 crore. And then it was won by Star Sports with a winning bid of 16,000 crore. In that meantime, from 2008 to 2018, Sony earned a profit of around 17,000 crore. And then it was took over by Star Sports. Next. Now the title sponsor. Who was the first title sponsor of Vivo IPL? And what was the bidding amount? Anyone? Chocolate. Yes, who? Yes, it's correct, it's 200 crore, the first bidding price, and it took it for 5 years. Next. And then PepsiCo came. PepsiCo actually he took the contract for 5 years, but he continued for 3 years, because from 2015 to 2016 some controversies came, like you all know that CSK and Rajasthan Royals were disqualified from the tournament because of some controversies. Huh? And then PepsiCo also left, so he was paid an amount of 238.77 crores. But PepsiCo signed the contract for 5 years at 397 crore. Next. And last, Vivo took over the charge with a winning bid of 2,199 crore, and it is still continuing till present. So apart from this sponsorship, I would like to give you a stats of Seat Tire strategic timeout. And I already mentioned the sponsor also in strategic timeout, it is Seat. Okay, I was about to ask this question again. But I would give you one statistics. In Seat Tire strategic timeout, how much income do IPL makes? I guess it will all leave you in shock. So how many minutes does Seat Tire strategic timeout takes place? 1 minute 30 seconds, right? 2 minutes 30 seconds. So in one innings, 5 minutes, overall 10 minutes, means in one match 10 minutes. And in IPL, when advertising takes place, for each second IPL charges 10 lakhs rupees from the advertising company. So total amounts to total time is how much? 10 minutes. 10 minutes how much seconds? Into 10 lakhs. So it is coming around at 342 crores per match. Okay, so now you can calculate that it takes to, in IPL 60 matches are being played, and you can calculate the total amount of money IPL receives within this CA time strategic timeout. So the official sponsors are Hotstar VIP and Dream 11. Next. And the associate sponsors are Swiggy, Dairy Milk and Maruti Suzuki.
Oh, it's gone. And it's gone far.
Did you guys saw that ball going out? And did that it came down? No, so that's how the revenue of IPL went up, higher and higher, and it has not came down up till now.
Thank you.
From 2016, it was 285 crore. Till now, 2019, it is now 431 crore.
So this is the profit comparison with the other leagues. What are the other leagues apart from IPL? BBL, PCL, so you can see that they are no in comparison with IPL, because the profit is 213 crore for IPL. So what is the reason behind this? Can anyone tell? Large audience. Oh, okay. Next, the SWOT analysis. So in spite of telling that IPL is totally a business model, still how many of you are a fan of IPL? How will you still watch IPL? So the strength is strong fan following. They have got a good number of brand ambassadors. The weakness are price of the tickets and losing mass appeal due to the controversies. You all know about the controversies. Opportunities are growing number of teenagers who likes T20 concept a lot in nowadays. And India is truly a cricket nation, cricket crazy nation. And the threats are emerging of several other T20 leagues, though it is not an important threat. And intervention of the government bodies.
Now conclusion, IPL is the most successful cricket league due to its marketing strategy, and it is very important to have the great marketing strategy for having such successful business. No matter how big your brand is, your business will not work unless you offer something exciting. Thank you.
Thank you so much.